My social media is back with Nykaa Pink Friday sale. What's new? That website has got a sale 24/7, 365 days a year. But I'm here to make things a little different for you because I've got a whole playlist, guys, of what to buy whenever there is a sale at Nykaa. So please hit that iCard out here. It'll take you to the playlist. Just in case you're thinking of buying a thing or two, you've got that little budget to buy something for you, then this is the time to hit that playlist so that shopping can be a lot more easier. But today's video, I'm going to be telling you what to avoid during the Nykaa sale. But sometimes there are many hyped about products that, in my opinion, this is just my opinion, it's all subjective out here, in my opinion, these can be avoided, you know, during the sale time or generally otherwise. All right, so let's start. My name is Shweta Vijay. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. And I hope you take that moment to hit that subscribe button and be a part of my family. And don't forget to follow me on my Instagram. That is at Shweta Vijay Nayar. Shall we get this party rolling? Let's dance. So the first thing that I'm going to start off with is this hyped about product. I've seen so many people speak about it. This is the Dot & Key Cica Calming Niacinamide Sunscreen SPF 50. I'm not saying that this is the worst SPF. This is pretty good actually, but just hear me out. Now, I have done my top 16 sunscreen video, no white cast sunscreen videos. I categorized it from mineral to pharma brands all the way to Indian, commercial Indian skincare brands that produce the best of the best. And that time also, when I was making that video, because it's a very comprehensive list that I did, I was also testing this one out. There were a couple of questions saying that, why didn't you include this? I wanted to include this, but on repeated use, I started noticing that when I sweat also, I can feel the sunscreen on me, you know, though it is waterproof, sweatproof, whatever that it claims to be, it feels a lot more thicker and I feel there is a product sitting on my skin. That's number one. Number two is that it took a while for that white cast to completely disappear on my skin. Now, the Minimalist SPF 60 also does the same thing, but after about a minute or two, it disappears on the skin. This is not like that. If you have a deeper skin tone, I feel that this is going to take a lot more time for the white cast to completely go away. It is going to, you know, be... it is going to make itself visible and come up and say hi to you. Otherwise, the sunscreen is so lightweight in texture. Niacinamide is known to control oil production. I'm going to get a lot of heat on this because I know how many people love this. But the third and the most important thing that is really troubling my sense of smell is, there's no fragrance out here. They've kept it so that it's perfect for people with all sorts of skin type, even sensitive skin. Very strong smell, and I don't like that. It just troubles my sense of smell, and it just doesn't go away even after you apply this, after about 5 minutes, and I've got a nose of a bloodhound. This troubles my sense of smell, and that is something I'm not enjoying at all. Oh, it shouldn't be like this. This is too... chemically for my liking, so a big no to this. So this is something you can avoid during the sale or not. Oh, where do I start with another popular brand? Minimalist. You guys know I love Minimalist as a brand. I think they're doing really good stuff, and I think this is the reason that when even The Ordinary launched here in India, I expected The Ordinary to sell out. I've done very recently, I think 3 weeks ago, I did a video on Best of Minimalist, the reformulated one, so please check that video. It'll give you my top best of the best. Over there, I did not include vitamin C, and many people were like really upset saying that, why not the vitamin C? So this one is the vitamin C 10% face serum. Both the vitamin C that I have tried, the other vitamin C, which I'll talk about much later, is a little better. For me, when I started applying that, I did break out, but eventually my skin adjusted to it. So I'm assuming it was a skin purge moment. This one keeps breaking me out no matter what I've done, and I've really tried my level best to make this one work. I even tried it before the video, and as you can see, I'm suddenly got bumps all over. I get these small whiteheads or these really tiny painful bumps all over my cheeks and on my jawline area. This is not working for me. And I know vitamin C many people love from the Minimalist. So I guess skincare is very subjective, you guys. But for me, this is not working. I have tried. You know, I really test it out. I really give it a proper shot before saying a yes or a no. This is a big no for me. And I think there are better vitamin C in the market. Now that The Ordinary is available, you can, you know, rather go for the vitamin C from The Ordinary. So many other, Deconstruct has made really good vitamin C. Martyrdom has made really really good vitamin C, pure bubbles, and Dr. Chef's vitamin C is even better, the 20%. I made a reel on this, and the amount of messages I received saying that what I said was right, that they also broke out and it irritated their skin. So something about it is just not formulated right, I feel. So let's move on to the next one. Number three is Aqualogica. Now, Aqualogica is a sister brand of Mama Earth, and they've got two sister brands, Aqualogica as well as Dermaco. And I really started liking a few Aqualogica products, like their sunscreen is pretty decent, and there are many other skincare products which I can talk about. The pink variant and the yellow variant, that reminds me so much of Glow Recipe, you guys. So if you cannot get your hands on some Glow Recipe products, I'm going to be able to give you dupes of it, because I'm testing it out, and they are so similar, moisturizers and their mask, and I've been really enjoying it. The scent of it, the feel of it is just great. Now this one, this is the Hydrate Refresh Toning Mist. This has got coconut water and hyaluronic acid. This one, as well as the moisturizer, which is going to be my next one, this is the Hydrate Sorbet Cream Moisturizer, and the Green Radiant Sunscreen also, which I've spoken about. You can avoid this like the plague, because this is like knocking on the Old Spice door, you know, one of those aftershave, that's the kind of fragrance that comes out of it. If you have a boyfriend, your dad, or any man in the family might enjoy this, because it's a shame. The cream, you know, the moisturizing cream is so super hydrating. So you can use this on the body if you're not very fond of the face cream. That's what I've been doing. And this one, I've been spritzing it under my arms and, you know, on my body, because I don't want this on my face. The toner is so lightweight, and it's just a shame that if they can take this fragrance out that is so overwhelming and lingering and gives you a headache. Like I mentioned on my Instagram, if migraine was an object, it would be these green variant of Aqualogica products, you know, that's what it was. That's the example. It overwhelms you, and I don't like fragrance that strong. I don't have a problem with fragrance, you guys know that a little bit, you know. It's always nice to have that pleasurable experience when you're doing your skincare, so I don't mind a little bit of fragrance. But when it is too much like this, where you're actually thinking of taking a toner and wait one second. because so many of you had wrote to me saying that they have discontinued the Green Radiant. No guys, they haven't. It's still available. So if you come across this, because I think they're getting rid of old stock, or I don't know what it is, like even when I went for the Aqualogica launch, in my goodie bag they put the Green Variant. So that's why I like the yellow variant and the pink one also. Pink has got that watermelon kind of a scent. It's beautiful, very Glow Recipe. This definitely isn't. Now if you followed me on Instagram, you must have seen my reels where I'm testing out a lot of makeup items that promises to be this blurring thing, that promises to control that oil production, promises to, you know, make your pores a lot more smaller. Makeup stuff I'm talking about. Like that, I've done so many other various products. So when I heard about this metal priming balm that is supposed to minimize pores and give you a blurring effect, this is from Sugar Cosmetics. Now this is a primer which you're supposed to take a little bit and you're supposed to blend, but it is so silicone-y, you guys. First of all, look at that. I've already hit pan, and I've only used this 3 times. Nor does it minimize the pores. Makeup doesn't sit very well. It balls up. It cracks the makeup. It is so difficult to make that work and to spread it across the face. And look at that. Look how it just balls up. It's a horrible, horrible makeup product. What a disappointment this one is. Now, Forever 52. This makeup brand, I am actually a very big fan of, because they've got a lot of hits than the ones that just doesn't work. And this is the Unbelievable Daily Forever 52 Mascara. This is their new launch. And no, this is not working for me. I had such high hopes for this, because when they invited me to their office in Dubai, they were talking about this mascara. They were talking about how they are banking on this mascara to be almost like benefit kind, you know, to give you that really false lash effect, and because of the wand applicator. So as you can see, the wand reminds me so much of Essence False Lash Princess mascara thing. But it just doesn't give me the volume, it doesn't give me the length, it gives me clumpy lashes. I have Lash Princess Essence Mascara on, and this won't even give me, it's half the price, and it won't even give me the same effect as this beautiful, affordable one that's been my all-time favorite. I mean, every makeup has got good and bad, but this definitely The same thing is for the Glitz waterproof. This is the eyeshadow liner. Now, I've heard so many people talk about this eyeliner. It's this stunning metallic finish, but that's about it. The tip applicator, it dries down, you guys. It's not a pleasurable experience when you're drawing a winged eyeliner. Can you see that? It's very, very streaky. The color payoff is quite bad, and I have tried shaking it and dispensing it as much as possible. And every time you check out the reviews, especially at Nykaa, you'll see that, you know, it's always sold out. And it's not long lasting. Like, if I have to really rub my skin, there, gone. So that's how it is. So that itself should tell you, like, that's something to worry about. So not something that I would buy. So you can avoid that as well. Now let's move on to Just Herbs. So this is their, so they came out with their new skincare. This is the Vitamin C Amla Licorice Root Brightening Face Mask. They've got the Vitamin C entire range of, you know, face cream and this and that. And this face mask looked promising whenever I read the reviews and I heard people talk about it. They said that they really like this face mask. So this can be completely subjective. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So the scent of this face mask, see, when you apply the face mask in general, it's nice. I mean, I'm not saying that it's going to give you the worst experience and your skin is going to burn out. It's an okay face mask. There's nothing great about this. But what I noticed is after I wash my face, whenever I apply this, my skin feels really dry. It feels as if it's sucked out all the moisture out of my skin and I need to apply something hydrating and more products on top of this. And brightening effect, it did not give. Whether, even if it's a sale or not, I think this is something you can completely avoid. We are moving on to Indulgio, and sometimes Indulgio has offers, and I've heard so much about their Brow Grow. So this is something that has got, you know, rosemary extract and so many oils, basically onion bulb extract, calendula flower extract. It's also got vitamin E. I've tried it. I've tried as much as possible. I don't know why it irritates my skin. Every time I apply this on my eyebrows, I feel like plucking my non-existing eyebrows anyway, you know. I just wanted, like, I scratch the living daylights out of it, that I'm afraid that nothing is going to grow. Anyway, it is like, you know, two caterpillars, you know, meeting for coffee. That's what my eyebrows look like. And I don't want to lose my anyway non-existent eyebrows. So this is not something I enjoyed, you guys. When you take the spoolie, you know, there's another one that sets the eyebrow. Go for that. That is brilliant. I know rosemary extract is great to promote hair growth, but I think it's a bit too strong when it's on this side, on your face skin. You know, I feel that it can be a little too sensitizing, especially for sensitive skin. I don't think that this is the one for you, but this one is a big no-no for me. So this is Warm Hibiscus Flower Pot Powder Blush from Flower Beauty. And I know Flower Beauty, everybody loves, especially during a sale, they want to pick up some Flower Beauty products. Their cream blushes are excellent, go for that. But this powder blush can be avoided. I don't know what it is. It's definitely not a blush. It's not pigmented at all. Or maybe it's because I've got some really horrid product from the Nykaa website. But this just gives you a slight, I mean, I could wear a pink highlighter and you don't see that, you know, beautiful flush of color unless you turn and the light hits it and you're like, pink highlighter, oh my god, it is too much. So looks pretty, no doubt, all that jazz is all there. I know many people love this as well, but no, it's not working for me. And this also, if you have textured skin like mine, it emphasizes it. Like the NARS Orgasm, not one of my favorite again. I still feel it's an overhyped product. I have mentioned in my what not to buy last year or 2 or 3 years ago. At least that gives some sort of a color payoff. This doesn't even do that. So no, no. We're finishing it off with two more products, and this is the BHA Clarifying Serum from Juicy Chemistry. Now, Juicy Chemistry did come out with their plant-derived actives, and what I mean by that is that if they are vitamin C, I have mentioned even in my monthly favorites, I absolutely love it, you guys. It's such a great vitamin C for anybody that is sensitive to, L-ascorbic acid or its derivatives, vitamin C derivatives. If you are allergic to that sort, then you can go for something that is extracted from Kakadu plum or blood orange. And that vitamin C is even my brother's favorite because he's got extremely sensitive skin and cannot take any sort of vitamin C on his skin. He loves that. It does take a lot of time. It does take a lot of time for you to see a difference on your skin. It would take about even 2.5 months to 3 months with that vitamin C. But when it does, you will feel your skin looking brighter. Your complexion gets better. The same thing, this one is derived from willow's bark as well as curcumin, turmeric. I don't know. It didn't work for me. For me, I require a salicylic acid. When it comes to a troublesome breakout, you need a product that is going to work immediately. You can't wait for a month. You can't wait for 2 months. No matter whether it's from curcumin or whatever, you need something that will give you immediate results when it comes to reducing breakouts. Otherwise, what's the use of applying, you know, products like this? And this just did not do anything for me. No, guys, not for me. And sadly, I can't even recommend this to even people who are starting off with, you know, I'm talking about if there was young skin that wanted something, a skincare that would help with the breakouts. This is not a product that will help. It's a product that will aggravate it a lot more. So completely avoid this. Last but not the least is this one. This is from Dr. Sheth. This is the Medi Facial at Home High Strength Peel. And So I again saw so many of my favorites on Instagram speak about the facial peels that they came out with. So this has got 10% glycolic acid, 10% lactic acid, 5% mandelic acid, 5% BHA, 2% BHA and aloe vera extract. Oh boy, the way this made my skin itch. And I am someone who is okay with certain exfoliating agents and ingredients. I'm okay with it. You know, I've been trying out skincare products. I've been testing out for a very long time, you guys. I like the texture of this. It's really lightweight, cooling to touch or whatever, but I don't know what it is. It irritated my skin. I think it was too many things happening out here. There is another one with a lower percentage. Now that worked for me very well. So I don't know whether the years of using now skincare and testing out has made my skin very sensitive. So I'm just saying that if you've got extremely sensitive skin, maybe this is not the one for you. But this is a lot more stronger, isn't it? So you will feel your skin looking a little brighter because it's exfoliating the skin. But it left my skin feeling very dry. This is something that you can use every week. That's what it was formulated for, to make it a lot more gentler. Or they're low strength peel, go for that one. That is much better than the high strength peel. That would work better for sensitive skin. So that is just my opinion. So I hope you enjoyed watching what not to buy from Nykaa. I hope it makes shopping a lot more easier. If you still want to hear my recommendations, you can go to the playlist or let me know under this video whether you want me to do more of what to pick up from Nykaa, and I shall do it for you. You know, I've got your back always. I love you guys so much, and until later, bye for now.